Hello everyone. As we have discussed in this particular slide, so project planning, which has different phases, just designing a work breakdown structure, execution plan, and the procedural manual. So to do this, we need a project team. So in every project, the team plays very important role in designing and implementing the project or program. So usually the project team consists of, or it will have, the initial project team, usually the project manager, who will do the project initiation. So we have already discussed, project initiation will be done with the project charter. One diagram I had shown you, just I will show you that diagram again. Okay, yeah, here you see, in this diagram you can see the project initiation is done by the project charter. And what is project charter and how it is used, all these things we have discussed in the previous video. So project initial team, that which it is, or a project manager or his team initially designs a project, then designated project leader or a manager, core project team or a project streaming committee. So I'm just naming these things because what are these things we will be discussing in the next slide. Full project team, project advisors, project stakeholders, those will be monitoring regularly the projects. So here if you see the project charter, I want to show you the diagram of the project charter. Here what is the team I want to discuss, here you see steering committee. This will be always keeping an eye on the project. Let's say it includes the CEO, supply chain manager, and all these things. So these are all the teams. Okay, so and how these functions we will discuss. Then process facilitator. So once again, if I go back and see the charter, who is a facilitator, we can get idea here. Here you see supply chain manager, chief financial officer. These are all the facilitators who will be providing the facilities in regular interval to the project team. So he is a part of the, or they are the part of the project. Now let us discuss about initial project team. This, as it, the name itself suggests, these people are involved when initially the project is started. It starts from designing the charter. Sometimes the team members may or may not be part of the team. So this particular team is called as an initial team, which will build some outline to the project, how the project will go on. Next, if you discuss about a project leader or a manager, he is a person or the persons, the leader of the project, who will be responsible for planning and execution of the project, of the team members to be, and also he is responsible for defining or selecting the team members and how they need to be designated. All these things are decided by the project leader, maybe called as a project manager also. He is responsible for coordinating the activities among the team members. So how the team has to work in the different levels of the project, that is managed or coordinated, we can use a word called as a coordinated, how he is going to coordinate the team members, that is the responsibility of the project manager. And project manager also needs to manage the key stakeholders, means he has to give the feedback to the sponsors, CEO, those will be the stakeholders. So it is very important to manage the better business relationship with the stakeholders such as sponsors or the CEOs of the company, or we can call them as the stakeholders. Now the next is core project team. It's a small group of 3 to 8 people who are responsible for designing and managing the project. It's also called as a project steering committee. Okay, we'll just check it, which includes a sponsor, the client leader support specialist, and internal auditor. I want to check this charter. Here you see project steering committee, which will include the leader. CEO is head of the company. Then these are the project steering committee. This is one of the team, project team, which we have, you can see in the charter example what I have displayed it. So as you can see here, the sponsor, who is the CEO, and some required persons will be involved in the core project team. Next comes the full project team. It is bigger compared to core project team. It consists of a complete group of peoples who are involved in designing, implementing, monitoring, learning from the project. So what is this designing, implementing, monitoring? I don't want to discuss these things now, because these are the topics only we are discussing in this particular unit. This particular team may can include the managers, stakeholders. See, stakeholder is a person who will be financing, so his involvement may be there in any of the team. So this team includes the managers, stakeholders, researchers, and other key implementers of the project. So that is why the team could be very large. Next are the advisors, who are not the people in the project team, but sometimes they may be dependent on the honest feedback or counseling from these members. This is right, this is wrong, how it is going, it's going correct or not. These are the things what are discussed by these people, or these are the people who give the feedback and who can anchor the cause of the project. Next is the project stakeholders. So we have already discussed about what is a stakeholder. Yeah, I have one diagram for you guys here. What is stakeholder? See here, this also not in your textbook. I have picked it from Google. I hope it is visible to you. The stakeholder may be, what is the problem? Okay, this I will list. Something went wrong. I will reopen the diagram. Yeah, now you see here. So and when we talk about the stakeholders, he may be an investor, shareholder, partner, media, press. These are all stakeholder. That is why I said the scope may vary based on the stakeholder. It may be a customer also who is using that product, or who is benefited by that particular project. It may be a community group, it may be a trade group. These are all the stakeholders. Okay, so stakeholders are individual or groups or institutions who have visited, who have vested interest in maybe the natural resource. Sometime what happens, there may be some natural resource projects, so many people will be getting benefited or interested in that. Some may be to get a revenue. So for example, you take oil refineries. So if you take a Reliance, Indian Oils, or all these things, they are the stakeholders who have, or sponsors who have invested, and they get money from them, means they get the economical benefits. But we are also stakeholders because we need a product, petrol or a diesel, for, or even kerosene for our day-to-day requirement. So we are also stakeholders. So that petrol is, or a refinery is, a natural resource. So these are the stakeholders who will be economically or on the basis of needs will be directly or indirectly involved. And they will be affected by the project activities and something they will gain or lose because of this project. So stakeholders find a key place in the project team, because if you take a CEO of the company, he want to know the status of the project in each and every step of the project development. So they are the key factors. Next comes the project facilitator, who is a person can help the project team through the planning process. He is a part of the initial and core team. The project facilitator understands the key elements of the process and has a good facilitation skill. I want to just check the charter once again. Steering committee, no specific facilitator we have mentioned here. So he is one of the very key factor into the team, project team.